It's inspired by a true story about the people who actually found a debug box on eBay, on the internet, bought it, and then all sorts of weird things started happening. And actually the guy who bought the box, his mom got a stroke, and a lot of accidents started to happen in the family. And he found out that a debug box was actually an ancient Hasidic tradition, was a box in which you contained an evil spirit. You know, from exorcisms, the spirit leaves the body, but where to leaves it, you know? In the Catholic religion, it's actually just relieving the person from the demon. But in the Jewish tradition, you have to take it somewhere. So they actually carpentered a box and put it in there and made it sure it couldn't get out again. I think what we tried to do with this movie was to see if we could reinvent the genre. There's been so many movies in this genre. And usually you see these little girls or boys getting possessed and they start talking with deep voices and have red glowing eyes and twists their head around and 360 degrees head spins and weird sorts of things. What we tried to do with this film was to make it really real and to think about how would a girl like that actually react if she felt that she was getting possessed by something. And she doesn't react like, start speaking in a loud, dark voice or something like that. But she reacts by crying. Because it would definitely make me sad if I realized that I was being possessed by something. The film becomes a road movie when the dad actually goes out to search for the truth in order to try to save his daughter, who's slowly being eaten up by this debug, this demon, and goes to the Jewish neighborhoods in Brooklyn, Borough Park, where he actually finds the ancient rituals and the ancient story about the debug, and actually becomes, in some ways, one of the most scary scenes in the film. Not scary like horror as such, but more scary like as he finds all these elder Hasidic people. He realizes on the fear of their faces when he starts telling the story about the debug box, or when he shows them the debug box he's carrying. On the fear of their faces, he realizes how serious this is. I think it just symbolizes the evil within. And I guess that's the setup for all these kinds of stories about possessions, that that we like to watch stories about people being possessed by something evil and they turn evil and then we have to heal them again and get the evil out and they can become good persons and good human beings again. I'm not sure that's true. I don't think you get possessed by evil. I think that we are all evil. I think we're all good, but I think we're also all evil. So when those kinds of stories attract us, it's probably because we would wish we weren't evil, that we would wish the thought that something can actually possess us and make us evil. But I'm afraid that is not quite the truth about human nature. I think we all contain evil.